I found an interesting article in governmenttechnology.com. That's govtech.com, talking about, and the name of the article is Reimagining Interstate Rights of Way Could Bring Energy Boom. And so what I want to do here is show you a picture, if I
no,
may.
No, none of those pictures.
Of the idea here is that there are, literally tens of thousands of miles in the United States of space between interstates, between the roads. Now, here and in this article, they only talked about what they called the right-of-ways. And as you can see here in this picture, it's between the on-ramps and off-ramps is what they were focusing on. And so what they came up with is there's 127,000 acres of land like this, and it's a lot of land, and you can't build a building or anything on land like that. So what better use for something like that than to put solar panels? Now, they estimate 127,000 square acres, like I said, or 127,000 acres is enough to generate, they said basically it's, honestly not much. It's 36 terawatts of energy per year. Now, that sounds like a lot, 36 terawatts, but that's about 1% of the U.S. Energy consumption. But, the thing is, they admitted that not all of the states have very good data on the amount of space that is included in areas like that. And they think that once they get better maps and better land usage, then they would come up with a better and probably larger estimate. Now, again, they only focused on the on-ramps and off-ramps in the area in between there. And I really, as I was reading the article, was hoping that they would eventually say, not to mention the large strips of land between the lanes of the interstate. I mean, when you think of an interstate, it's separated and there's usually a lot, a strip of the land between there. Put solar panels between the, in that strip on the interstates, you could generate so much electricity and just have it run in series, just run, all the way down. Then you would think that there would be a lot of electricity that could be generated there. Yeah, I mean,
but that's anything. Solar would be great because, yeah, no one's going to build on it.
Exactly.
Except not for like those rest stop things in the middle.
Those are awesome. Yeah, you have the oases, of course. You have interstate oases. But the thing is, interstates don't have trees, except in South Carolina where they have tree farms down the middle. But for the most part, they're cut out. The trees are well away from the road, so you don't have to worry about obstruction. I just think this is a great idea. I'm glad to see people looking into it and researching it. And, anything we can do to burn less coal and natural gas is a step forward. So, I don't have much more on that. It's just, I think it's a great idea. I'm glad to hear people are talking about it.
And it goes really well with all the arguments. Oh, we don't have enough space for solar. We don't have enough space for solar. We've got the land. We've got, like you said, the on-ramps and off-ramps. We've got the space in between the interstates. We've got all the commercial and residential buildings that can support solar on the roof or right. In their, above the retention ponds. So somebody pointed out that the floating space above all of the reservoirs that we have for hydroelectric, it helps to retain more water. It's already space that you can't use anyway. Mm-hmm. We've got space.
Additionally, how many California freeways are filled with, toxic plants like oleander, which they have trouble getting rid of anyway. Mm-hmm. I think these solar islands make a whole lot of sense as opposed to using those kinds of plants for decoration.
Imagine. Hold on.
Okay.
Imagine if we took these solar panels and we connected them to on-road inductive charging.
Boom.
Imagine that every time you went by an overpass, your car charged a little bit. Imagine.
That would be hella cool, actually. That would be hella cool.
Yeah. Yeah. It really would be.
They get that idea for free.
Or they put the power under the interstate to power the electric semi trucks.
Well, or over, right? We saw that one with the road. little skate comes up and it rides on the wire, you know?
Sure. Which even more efficient technology than inductive charging and
mm-hmm. Right.
Yep. You would have to worry about the size of the space in between the two freeways. So I've seen U.S. freeways. They seem to be quite spread apart between the north and southbound lanes or east and westbound lanes. But in my region, there's not that much space on the major routes in between the two lanes of traffic. So it becomes a question of there have to be a certain amount of space in between because, you know, there's a bit of a runoff lane for people that get in an accident or spin off the road or whatever. Mm-hmm. You'd hate to be slamming into a solar array, you know, doing 70 miles an hour or decelerating from 70 miles an hour.
Let's try to take the win for our tendency to actually spread out like giant buckets of molasses spilt all over the place. The way how we just go, blah. Let's do something useful. So we're not a compact culture, is what I'm saying, Mark. We're basically middle-aged spread, but as a country.
Well, plus the panels, depending on your configuration, the panels are, what, 5 foot by 3 foot? Russell knows exact dimensions for average. They were 2 by 5 in forever.
It's a good rough figure, yes.
Yeah.
2 by 5, okay.
I think the other thing that this article does that I'm not really clear is a positive thing, and it didn't need to be a negative thing. It said that that if we put solar panels on all this land, it would only represent 1%. So what? So it's only 1%. That's okay. That's a lot of energy that's generated by clean means. It's not hurting anybody. That's not going to explode or spill or belch smoke. So it's only 1%. That's okay. We can diversify. We can take little steps. A lot of those mm-hmm. little steps, and we'll actually do something that makes a difference.
I'm sorry, Russell. It's not perfect. We shouldn't even try.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. The whole perfect is the enemy of the good.
yes. And again, I mean, the 1% was only what they came up with on the on-ramps and off-ramps. They
that was
didn't
like the little triangle pieces.
Exactly, right. The little triangle piece. But anyone who's driven east-west knows, you know, you have I-70, I-80. I mean, it runs for...
Yeah, most of the country, like there's like an acre miles. In between the east and the west bound.
Mm-hmm. Right, exactly. You could easily do this. And one more thing from the article that I thought was really good. Is that the municipality, the Department of Transportation that owns the land, is leasing the land to the utility company that is owning and maintaining the solar panels. So it actually is a little bit of revenue for the municipality. So
revenue positive.
Nothing wrong with that. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean. Yeah, there's tons of good that we could do if we just are willing to accept some little steps.
Well, they could use the power, like a lot of intersections, there's big high lamps to light it up at night, mm-hmm. you know, they could power those.
Absolutely. Right.
Yeah, so much good could come of this.
They could use it to build electric fences to shock little animals for no reason at all.
Oh my God. Well, that went dark.
But if you reduce the deer impacts and other wildlife.
See, shocking, poor harmless Bambi.
Well, you don't have to shock them, just deter them. And that then now you've saved millions of dollars in
wildlife.
What
drives us
wildlife.
In no way, shape, or form recommends using these areas to shock Bambi, Bambi's mom, Thumper's mom, any Disney animal.
I will call the lawyer right now.
I'm going to stick to that, and I'm going to suggest show title.